Hi, in this Affinity Publisher tutorial, I'm going to continue my series where we are looking at all the tools and windows in Affinity Publisher, and we're using version 2 for this. So we have worked our way through these first few tools. We skipped over the table tool, so let's come back to the table tool. So it is this one here that when you hover on it says table tool. We're going to select it, and then we can go anywhere on our document. And you can see we've got a different sort of cursor now. Instead of an arrow, it's like a crosshairs with a little grid next to it. And I'm going to hold my left mouse button and just drag out an area. Once we've dragged out our table, there's different things that we can do. So we can click on this bottom set of double arrows and a number pops up. That's how many rows we have. So let's say we want our table to have 10 rows. I can click in this and just type 10 and return or enter, and it will remove all those extra tables. Now, if I want to grab this dot here, now I can just stretch this out. Same thing up here. If I don't want this many columns, I can just click on this and I can either type the number or I can use the up and down arrow. So let's just reduce this to 3 with the down arrow. And now I have my table. So let's take a look at some of the things that we can manipulate with this. If you go up top here, at the very end, you will see a table icon. We're going to click that, and that brings up our table window. Another way that you can find that is through window and then just click on the table selection. And I'm just going to expand out this window a little bit because there's a few more options down there. So I just want to walk through the basic settings for tables. So this first section where it says frame, this is for the entire table. So if I want to add a stroke outline to my entire table, I would click the frame stroke. And then I could choose a color. Let's maybe make it purple. And it's pretty thin right now. So there's a stroke weight option right next to it. So let's click that. And then we can turn up the width. And I'm going to turn it up quite a bit. That way you can really see what some of these different options do. Okay, so with the table selected, I can also change the fill color. So let's say I've chosen that purple. And I want to just do a really light pink inside there. So that will fill the entire table. So anything that you want to do globally to the table as a whole is in this frame section. Now, when we have it selected, there's also some insets. And let's just kind of click on it and you can see what happens. So you can see how the grids are moving away from the outer border of the table. And it's kind of nice to be able to see that with this thick purple stroke on. So these insets move the entire table away from the border. So if I wanted to have this table kind of on a background like this, this is how I would do that. So I'm going to put this back to 0. And also, if you wanted to change those independently, so let's actually back up and move this. They are all changing at the same time right now because this little chain symbol is linked. But let's just say now I've got a big upper and lower border, but I've got a very narrow side border. I could unlink this and that would allow me to change the right side, change the left side, and then I could have a little bit more control over that. I'm going to control Z a few times to get rid of that option and get back to where we were. So we'll go back to 0 for all of these. And now we're back to our table. All right, so I'm going to just collapse that up because we're done with that one. Let's take a look at this next section. So this allows you to do some manipulations with the outlines of the individual cells. So if I click on one of these rows in the gray area, I can select an entire row at a time. So let's say I want to make this top section a darker color. So I could go to the stroke and fill section hit cell fill, which is this one here. And then I could go to my purples again and I could find a slightly darker color to make that. Now, if I wanted to have these cell lines be a different color, I've got some options here. I can do the whole outside border of a single cell. So if I just select a single cell, like that, then I can select all four borders and I can change the color of that to, let's make it kind of a dark purple. And so it's hard to see again because it is such a light stroke. But let's turn that up a little bit so that you can see it. Okay, and in those stroke options, I can also make it a dotted outline if I wanted to. I'm going to leave it solid. So let's turn all of these lines to be purple. So I'm going to find the one that gives me all vertical. We will change that to purple. And we will also make sure that the lines are all 2.5. So now my vertical lines are purple. And then select it again. And we're going to find the all horizontal option, which is this one here. And do the same thing. Pick a purple. We'll turn up the stroke weight a little bit. And now all of our lines are purple within there. All right, so that's the basics of the stroke and fill. It allows you to change the fill of individual cells as well as the border lines of individual cells. And you just have to look at the different icons here to see which part of the cell it's going to affect. If you hover, it will tell you, but you can also kind of just look and see which line is weighted more heavily in the diagram, and that's going to be the lines that'll be affected. All right, let's talk about the cell section. So this is where you can set exact widths for different cells. So let's highlight this column, and let's just say we want that one to be narrower. So we could adjust that in the cell width. Same thing with cell height. We can squish up cell height over here. Now the insets here are for the cell. The first set of insets we looked at up here in the frame section moved the table inside. It kind of created a margin around everything. These insets are at the cell level. So we can do that. We can demonstrate that by just typing some text in here. And I'm going to make it a little bit bigger so we can see it. Like that. All right, so now when I'm in this cell, I can change the insets by clicking the arrows, or I can just type numbers in. And you can see what that did is it just moved it away from the margins. And if I unlink these, I can make it more left independently. I can move it away or closer to the top. So you can get really granular with where you want the text in relation to the edges of the cell. This can be handy if you're making something like a calendar and you want the numbers to be a certain distance away from the edges of each box in your calendar. And then finally, in our vertical position, we can take this text and we can use vertical justification, to align it against the top. It's going to respect those insets that we set, and then you can do it in the middle or aligned against the bottom. And then if you had ones, you could justify it against the entire cell. So if we had multiple lines of text, it would just space it evenly between the top and bottom borders of that cell. And then kind of a fun thing, let's make our table a little bit bigger. I can also rotate this text in different directions. So if you want to have maybe a narrow column And here's another way you can change the columns is just click on it and in the gray area, hover until you get double arrows. And then I can narrow up this column even more. I can grab this one, narrow that up, and then let's squish this at the bottom. And now we've got our text in the vertical direction here. All right, so that is the basics of the table tool. There's really a lot you can do with this tool. I absolutely love the table tool. It makes it easy to lay out things neatly. And there's so many different ways that you can decorate it without having to, you know, fill every single shape or put shapes together. Table tool is awesome. I highly suggest you play around with it and learn to love it. All right, thanks for watching.